Shouts out to the pack. It is pack here,
aka your mama's best friend.
And it is time to overreact. The NBA season started, and every single team has played at least one game, except for the Rockets and the Thunder. And it's time to completely overreact about every single team and players that did well and basically predict what the next roster update is going to look like for NBA 2K21 on the next generation. Before this video starts, though, be an OG, join the pack, and subscribe. Now, I am with Joel Embiid and the 76ers, and I'm going to talk about Joel Embiid because he did fantastic in his first game. Listen to me when I say this, okay? Joel Embiid argued that he's probably the best big in the NBA besides Anthony Davis. He even says, I think I'm better than Jokic. And so, he believes that, and he started off the season right with a win and playing as the best player on the team easily and kind of like made his dominance known. So, that's a big deal for him. He actually might end up being the second best center in the NBA or gets big in the NBA. Another player that's super important is Shake Milton. They lost Josh Richardson. They needed someone that can shoot as well as they can because, you know, your two best players aren't really the best shooters in the world. So you needed to surround these players with shooters like Tobias Harris, Seth Curry, Danny Green, and now Shake Milton, who had a very good game. And I think he's actually going to be very important next season, or I guess this season. For the Bucks, the Milwaukee Bucks, it is Chris Middleton. He is leading the team with two games played, and I believe they're 1-1 right now. And I mean, Chris Middleton did pretty good, man. He is a baller who's consistent, who gets buckets. We always make fun of him being not good enough to be Giannis's number two or Giannis's Robin, but I mean, he's outscoring him right now, and that's a pretty big deal. Plus, Jrue Holiday's been playing solid, so that's also a pretty big deal. For the Bulls, the only one I can really talk about, because it's only been one game, is Patrick Williams. As a rookie, he's actually doing a very good job for starting in the NBA this way. He's playing very well. For the Cleveland Cavaliers, easily it is Colin Sexton and also Darius Garland, the two guards that may not be very good at defense, but offensively, they're amazing. They're both scoring at a very high level, at a very high clip. And they got a first dub of the year against the Hornets, I believe. So that's a pretty good win for them, and it's because of the two guards. Up next, it is the Boston Celtics, and the only player to talk about is Jaylen Brown. Dude is good. I was on a road trip with my friends the other day, and we were discussing hard who was better, Jaylen Brown or Kemba Walker. They were all saying Kemba Walker, but I was like, nah, dude, Jaylen Brown is really, really, really good. Y'all just don't know yet. He is one of the better players in the NBA, in my opinion, and he is probably easily the second best player on this team, and I think his 86 overall is too low. I think he's going to be maybe even in the 90s this season. He is so good. For the Los Angeles Clippers, it is Paul George, like, easily. Dude, we were talking so much crap about Paul George and how bad he's been playing. He heard all of it, and he was responding with it, and then some. He is the leading scorer on the team so far after two games. They're 2-0 right now, beating the freaking Lakers. And also beating the Nuggets, who literally beat him in a 3-1 lead, or blew, they were the reason they blew a 3-1 lead. So Paul George is really stepping up so far. Let's see if he can continue that throughout the year, though. That's the whole point. Also, someone I want to mention on the Clippers is Nicholas Batum, because he really hasn't played meaningful basketball in like 2-3 years. And he's been put on the Clippers as a starter and is actually doing a pretty good job. And that's a big deal for me, in my opinion. I think his rating is going to go up for sure. For the Grizzlies, I'd say John Morant. when he got 44 points, and you're leading the NBA in points per game after one game, obviously. He didn't have Jaren Jackson Jr. last game, and he still almost, well, competed against the Spurs with literally just him, and he did a really good job. With the Hawks, obviously, Trae Young, he scored amazing, and they won, and this team is actually very good on paper, and I think he's going to lead them probably to the playoffs, so Trae Young, but obviously someone else is Cam Reddish. He had a very good offseason, or I guess preseason, and on top of that, he's having a good regular season so far. That's a big deal. When you have a good preseason and start of the regular season, that usually has a pretty good meaning that you're going to be pretty decent. And I think Cam Reddish is going to be pretty good this year. For the team that went to the finals last year, Bam Adebayo, I believe, now is the best player on the team at the moment. I really believe Jimmy Butler was the best player last year. I really truly believe that. But Bam, this seems to have gotten even better. And if you watch him play, like, he just does everything so well. So it's hard to say anybody besides Bam. He even kind of lost weight, so he's even faster. I say Bam is the best player on this team right now, so I think he needs to go up. And then on top of that, Duncan Robinson is one of the best shooters in the NBA easily, and he's proving that right now when he's just making every open shot possible. He has to go up. For the Hornets, it's easily Terry Rozier. Scary Terry, bro, was going insane in this first game, getting like 42 or 44. I don't even remember, something in the 40s. He played amazing. Devontae Graham, I thought, was the best player on this team last year, and Gordon Hayward was a pickup that we all thought was probably going to be the best player. But Terry Rozier right now is looking like the best player on the team, at least at the moment. Yeah, for the Jazz, the only one to talk about is Mike Conley. He struggled last year, and this year he's looking pretty good so far, but we'll see. He was pretty rough last year, and they're going to need him to be good because they're going to need everybody to be good this year. Because I keep saying, on paper, this team is so good, they might be a contender, but it's going to depend a lot on Donovan Mitchell. If Bojan is as healthy as we hope he is, and Mike Conley needs to get better. So that's a big deal for him to play good. For the Kings, straight up Buddy Hield, easily the second best player on this team. I don't know why he's tied with Marvin Bagley. I don't know why Hassan Whiteside is considered better. Buddy Hield has always been good, one of the best shooters in the NBA, and is clearly, in my opinion, the second best player on this team behind De'Aaron Fox. And Hassan Whiteside needs to go down. He struggled in this first game. And I can't say that he's better than Buddy Hield. For the Knicks, easily RJ Barrett. I'd even argue RJ Barrett's the best player on this team right now. I don't know why he's so low here. He's easily the best player on this team. And that was, he had such a good game and he barely missed at all. I think he was like 11 for 15 in shots. So that's insane. And on top of that, Alec Burks played really well. And I mean, when you're averaging 15 points per game last season and you're on the Knicks, you're probably going to average even more. For the Lakers, I was going to say nobody, but nah. Kyle Kuzma has been playing very well. In the two games that he has played, he has not been missing much. He's been doing a very good job. I think he deserves more respect, and I think he definitely deserves to have an upgrade on this team, and I think he deserves to be considered the fifth best player behind Dennis Schroeder. For the Magic, Evan Fournier has been playing amazing, but he does this every year. He starts off the year amazing and averages a lot of points, and then throughout the year fizzles out, so whatever. For the Mavericks, technically, no one. Porzingis is out, so it's kind of hard for them to do what they want to do. But Luka obviously is playing amazing, and Josh Richardson's doing okay, but he's doing what we expect him to do. This team, everyone's hyping them up to be like the number one contender against the Lakers in the West, when it's just not true. Unless Porzingis can come back super healthy and never get hurt throughout the year or get tired, they're never going to be able to do what they need to do. I think right now, the Brooklyn Nets are easily the best team in the East. Like, after what I saw, their past two games, like Kevin Durant looks like he never got hurt, and Kyrie Irving is playing the best basketball I've ever seen him play. So, I mean, straight up because of that, I'm saying Kyrie Irving, and I think they're the favorites to win the East for sure. The Nuggets have needed Michael Porter Jr. to step up and be the third best player, and that's what he's been doing so far. He's been playing amazing. They lost against the Clippers, but still, he's been playing amazing. So for Indiana, I'm saying Domantas Sabonis. I saw him destroy the Knicks literally by himself, like he was dismantling them. So Domantas Sabonis is easily the best player on this team, and T.J. Warren should not be tied with him. And Malcolm Brogdon low-key is playing good, and Victor Oladipo is low-key playing good. So, yeah, this team is stacked. For the Pelicans, the one that needs to be talked about is J.J. Redick. He's been playing just as good as he was playing with the Sixers. He's playing the exact same with the Pelicans right now. He's doing very well. For the Pistons, the only person to really talk about, in my opinion, is Josh Jackson. Like I said, Josh Jackson had a really good preseason, and he had a very good first game, and that's a big deal. We're always waiting for Josh Jackson to kind of blow up, where he was always expected to be pretty good and he never did it. But on the Pistons, now that he's given a bigger role, he's playing well and he's showing us that he low-key could be like an important starter on any team. And he's starting to get a little better, and that's a big deal. On the Raptors, I'd say nobody, personally. I think nobody really did that good. I think Aaron Baines is pretty solid, but like, there's really no one to talk about. On the Rockets, obviously there's no one to talk about because they couldn't play, but I think James Harden needs to be downgraded because of how annoying he's been for his team, just straight up. For the Spurs, literally everyone. They had such a good game against the Grizzlies for their first game of the year. They were playing just like how they were playing in the bubble, and if they keep playing that way, they could be a playoff team. On top of that, I think Derek White needs to be healthy and back. And if he plays the way he was playing in the bubble, we're low-key a really good team, in my opinion. Patty Mills played great. I think somebody that needs an immediate upgrade is Keldon Johnson because he played fantastic. And Lonnie Walker. Oh, Lonnie Walker needs the biggest upgrade out of everybody. Only a 73 overall for him is blasphemy. For the Suns, Chris Paul and Devin Booker are tied for the best player. And that's just, Chris Paul actually had a pretty solid game, even though the stats didn't show it. But Devin Booker is easily the best player on this team and needs to be rating-wise. And then Michael Bridges had, or Mikal Bridges, had a very, very good first game. I think getting 18 points. So he probably, if he keeps playing like that, is definitely going to need to be upgraded as well. And the Thunder didn't even play, so we can't talk about them. For the Timberwolves, two players. First, Malik Beasley had a very good first game. Anthony Edwards actually also had a very good first game too, to be honest. And then on top of that, D'Angelo Russell was pretty clutch. So everyone there, I think, deserves an upgrade. For the Blazers, I want to talk about Melo. There was no Damian Lillard last game, and Carmelo Anthony was the second best player on this team in that game, and that's a big deal. When everybody was trashing him, saying that he doesn't even deserve to be in the league, people said that, and yet he had a really good game. I'm so glad that I never stopped believing in Melo, because he's showing everybody that they're so wrong about him. For the Warriors, oh my god, they have been struggle city, All because, honestly, Klay Thompson and Draymond have not been on the team. And Curry is literally being, like, quadruple teamed every possession. And Andrew Wiggins and Kelly Oubre can't hit an open shot. So it's a really big struggle for them. But James Wiseman has been thriving, for sure. It's so impressive what he's been doing. We're looking at maybe the rookie of the year because he's averaging 22 points, right? Think about that. In two games. And he didn't play a single preseason game and didn't get a train because he was injured. That's crazy. And finally on the Wizards, I think Russell Westbrook. I think he had a very good first game, even though they lost against the Sixers. The Sixers aren't a bad team, and this team is barely a playoff team. So the fact that they did pretty good against them, and they're barely, like, they're new and they don't know how to play together yet, and Russell Westbrook had a very good game, I think is a really good sign. Okay, that's what I believe. Do you agree or disagree with anything? Leave it in the comments below. And if you like this channel, give it a sub, and I'll see you guys next time.